gotta say, that is a serious bottle of beer. Y'all don't mess around.
Supporters are believing that he can indeed.
I am thrilled to be with you. Thank you for coming out. It was such a pleasure. To be with so many freedom-loving patrons. Chris, Michael, thank you both for your passion, for your leadership. Thank you for standing together. Thank you. Let me say to the students, I'm glad I was able to get y'all out of class this morning. And I will make one commitment to the students. If Heidi Cruz becomes first lady, meat is coming back to the lunchroom. Call me crazy, but I think the cardboard belongs under the tray and not on the tray. You know, a lot of y'all in your classes, you may well have learned that if you study the roots of the world, you can learn a lot about where it comes from. If you look at the roots of the word politics, it has two parts. Poly, meaning men, and tics, meaning blood-sucking parasites. And that is a fairly accurate description of Washington, D.C. And yet we're here this morning for something a lot more important than the politics. We're here because our country is in crisis. Because we're bankrupting our kids and grandkids. Because our constitutional rights are under assault each and every day, and because America has receded from leadership in the world. And yet I am here this morning with a word of hope and encouragement all across New York, all across this country. People are waking up. And help is on the way. This next election is going to focus on three critical issues: jobs, freedom, and security. Let's start with jobs. I want to take a minute and talk to all the single moms who are working 2 and 3 part-time jobs, who've seen your hours forcibly reduced to 28, 29 hours a week because Obamacare kicks in at 30 hours. I want to talk to all the truck drivers, all the plumbers and electricians, all the machinists, all the union members, all the men and women with calluses on your hands. We've seen wages stagnating year after year after year. Cost of living, it keeps going up. And yet somehow your paycheck doesn't seem to keep pace. I want to talk to all the young women. Come out of school with student loans up your eyeballs. Scared. And I'm going to get a job. What is the future hold for? And you know, the media tries to tell us this is the new normal. This is as good as it gets. Let me tell you, that is an absolute lie. You know, it's easy to talk about making America great again. You can even print that on a baseball game. But the real question is, do you understand the principles and values that made America great in the first place? Yeah. the heart of our economy is not Washington, D.C. The heart of our economy is small businesses all across the United States of America. You want to see the economy take off, you take the boot of the federal government off the back of the necks of small businesses. If I'm elected president, we will repeal every word of Obamacare. It is the biggest job killer in America, and in its place, we will pass common sense health care reform that makes health insurance personal and portable and affordable and keeps government from getting in between us and our doctors. And we will pass a simple flat. Where every American can fill out our taxes on a postcard. And when we do that, we should abolish the IRS. We're gonna rein in the EPA. Regulators who have descended like locusts on small businesses, killing jobs all across this country. And we're going to stop amnesty and secure the borders and end sanctuary cities and end welfare benefits for those here illegally. Let me tell you what's going to happen when we do all that. We're going to see millions and millions of new high-paying jobs coming back to America. We're going to see jobs coming back from China, coming back from Mexico. We're going to see manufacturing jobs back in America again. We're going to see wages rising in America again. We're going to see young people coming out of school with 2, 3, 4, 5 job offers. We'll see mourning in America. The second critical issue of this election is freedom. You know, just a few weeks ago, the passing of Justice Scalia underscored the stakes of this election. It is not just one, but two branches of government that hang in the balance. We are one liberal justice away from a radical five-justice left-wing majority, the likes of which this country has never seen. We are one justice away from the Supreme Court stripping religious liberty from millions of Americans. We are one justice away from the Supreme Court effectively erasing the Second Amendment from the Bill of Rights. We are one justice away from the Supreme Court making us subject to the World Court and to the United Nations and international law and giving up U.S. sovereignty.
Don't pick Andrew Cuomo.
All right, you convinced me. You know, 2 debates ago, Hugh Hewitt asked us all a question about religious liberty in the Supreme Court. And Donald Trump turned to me. He said, "Ted, I've known a lot more politicians than you have." Well, in that, He is correct. Donald Trump has been supporting liberal Democratic politicians for 40 years. I have no experience with this. But Donald continued. He said, Ted, when it comes to religious liberty, when it comes to the Supreme Court, he said, Ted, you got to learn to compromise. You got to learn to cut deals with the Democrats and go along to get along. Well, let me be very, very clear to the men and women of New York. I will not compromise away your religious liberty. Away your Second Amendment right to keep and bear arms. That means to the Catholic schools all across this great state, to the Jewish day schools across this great state. That means to the McGill Christian Academy. Constitutional right to live according to your faith and your conscience without government getting in the way. The third critical issue in this election is security. For 7 years, we've seen a president who abandons our friends and allies. And it shows weakness and peace in its words. You know, again, 2 debates ago, Donald Trump made very clear, he said, if he were president, he would be neutral between Israel and the Palestinians. Well, let me be very clear. As president, I will not be neutral. Will stand unapologetically with the nation of Israel. And you know, anyone who can't tell the difference between our friends and our enemies, who can't tell the difference between Israel and Islamic terrorists who want to kill us, that raises real questions about their fitness and judgment to be commander-in-chief. For 7 years, we've seen our military undermined. We've seen readiness weaken. We've seen morale of the troops plummeting. And you know what, as a nation, we've seen this before. We've seen another left-wing Democratic president, Jimmy Carter, who weakened and undermined the military. And then, in January 1981, Ronald Reagan came into office. And what did Reagan do? Reagan cut taxes, he pulled back regulations, he saw small businesses explode. New high-paying jobs that generated trillions in new government revenue, and he used that revenue to rebuild our military, to bankrupt the Soviet Union, and to win the Cold War. I intend to do the exact same thing with radical Islamic terrorists. We're going to repeal Obamacare, pass a flat tax, pull back the regulators, stop amnesty. We're going to see millions and millions of new high-paying jobs come back to America. wages going up again. That's going to generate trillions in new government revenue, and we will use that revenue to rebuild our military so it remains the mightiest fighting force on the face of the planet.